have amidst Professor S.K. Singh, who according to me is dynamism and dignity personified. Professor S.K. Singh, MBA and PhD from FMS BHU, has made important contribution to the area of human resource management, organizational behavior, and general management by way of publishing numerous articles and books. Not only he has been head and dean of the Faculty of Management Studies, BHU, Professor Singh has also held key administrative positions in the university like Chief Proctor, Chairman of the Placement Cell, etc. He's also serving as expert member in various panels of AICT and UGC, and also as member of Board of Studies and Governing Councils of many universities and management institutes. Professor Singh is playing key role in policy formulation in the university at various capacity. Professor Singh has also been honored with many reputed national and international awards. Professor Singh also holds the honor of being one and only from FMS BHU to get deputed as ICCR Chair Professor Management of Ministry of External Affairs in the year 2012 in the Pokhara University, Nepal.
Respected Chairperson of the function, Professor A.D.N. Vajpayee, the Honorable Vice Chancellor of Himachal Pradesh University. Respected Chief Guest of the function, Professor Khadal, the Honorable Vice Chancellor of UP Technical University. Most respected Professor B.P. Singh, and I think that he doesn't need any kind of introduction. The Director of School of Management Sciences, Professor Jha, the organizing, the coordinator of this conference, my young friend Sandeep Singh, very important dignitaries sitting off the dais. I could see Dr. M.P. Singh, Sarjeev, S.K. Singh Saab, Anil Singh Saab. The delegates who have come from different institutions, students and friends. At the very outset, I would like to express my deep felt gratitude and thankfulness to the organizers, School of Management Sciences, for inviting me for this wonderful conference on a very unique theme, Spirituality, the Essence of Ethical Leadership and Management. So I would like to congratulate School of Management Sciences for this novel effort. Spirituality, Ethical Leadership and Management. To me, the spirituality is an elusive word, because I have not found any universally accepted operational definition of this word. And it is very obvious. Obvious because spirituality is time dependent and also the context specific. With the passage of the time, with the change of the context, perhaps this spirituality will be taking a different shape and different meaning. A few years back, almost three decades back, spirituality was considered as an off-track subject, particularly by the corporate people. But now the corporate people do realize that the solutions to many of the questions or problems, it can be obtained through spirituality. Again, I would like to congratulate the School of Management Sciences, because it could sense 20 years back the importance of spirituality in the corporate life, and it established a separate center of spirituality and human enrichment. And let me tell you that this center was not created merely for creating the center. Throughout, it has been very active, very vibrant, and has been organizing a number of activities. It also brings out a wonderful journal, Purusharth. I have been a regular reader of this journal, and let me tell you that many of the articles, they have given me a new insight into the corporate functioning and the corporate working. And I hope that if the corporate people, if we go through this kind of literature, they will also develop a better insight and they can better their performance. I would like to raise a very simple question in the beginning. What do we all aspire for in our life? What do we aspire for? There could be a number of replies to this basic question. And if you analyze the different replies, you will find a common thread running through all the replies. And perhaps that common thread would be that a happy and fulfilled life, that is what we all aspire for. Happy and fulfilled life. Now the second question that will follow naturally, it will come to our mind, how these aspirations can be fulfilled. Whether these aspirations can be fulfilled only by material prosperity or only by obtaining the material things, perhaps the answer will be a no big. Only the material prosperity and the so-called economic development cannot make the human mankind happy and cannot make the humankind to lead a fulfilling life. So we have witnessed the last century a phenomenal growth in the science and the technology, and it has added to the quality of human life, no doubt. There can't be two opinions, but that is the only one side of the coin. And as an academician, we cannot ignore the other side of the coin, which is at least equally important, or you can say which is more important than this material prosperity. So do we think that? I am just posing a few questions. As a corporate, we should focus only on increasing the capital base and the wealth maximization should be our objective. Or we should also focus on the environment, the universe, the cosmos, the ecosystem, and more particularly the human resources. As a generation, we cannot be selfish. We cannot go for economic development, which is of course meeting our needs, but at the same time, which is ignoring the prospect of the future generation. That we can't do, because the future generation will never forgive us. So we have to go for an economic development, which of course could improve the quality of life of the present generation, but at the same time, it does not limit the ability of future generation to fulfill their objective. I am an academician, so I raise the question for myself. Has the higher education got any role to play in improving the quality of leadership and improving the quality of leadership through spirituality? There can't be two opinions. That the higher education has got a tremendous potential to improve the quality of leadership in any society, whether it is our society or it is the society of European countries, it will improve. Recently, a qualitative study was conducted just to find answer to two basic questions. The first question was whether the spirituality helps the students, particularly the student activists, to exercise their leadership for social change. This was the first question which the study was aiming at. The second question was whether this higher education can provide a climate that can help the student to improve the spirituality? These were the two questions, the answer to which the study was trying to find out. And ultimate outcome was there was a good connectivity between the spirituality and the leadership. I am citing this research example which was conducted about 8 years back, just to indicate the tremendous potential which a higher education has got to improve the leadership or to improve the spiritual based leadership, to improve the leadership quality of the students. I have gone through the vision and the mission statement of many of the institutions. And again, I have found a common thread. And that thread is, one of the vision is to develop the leadership skill and to make the student socially sensitive. So I think that the higher education has got a tremendous role to play in this direction. With these words, I hope that the forthcoming technical sessions will be trying to answer this question and many more questions pertaining to the ethical leadership. But one thing is very clear, that only the material prosperity cannot make the human mankind happy. We will have to look beyond the material prosperity. And perhaps that beyond zone will be enriching the self. And that is the basic purpose of the establishment of the center of spirituality and human richness. Unless we are able to enrich ourselves, our inner self, we cannot bring the spirituality and the ethical issues in leadership and in the management functioning. With these words, once again, I wish the conference to be a great success. Thank you.